who are 17-4, 6-2 in the Big 12. Bruce Weber told us today at the shoot-around his team must be focused. There's the four-guard lineup. Rodriguez, Spradling, Magruder, and Southwell. And Jordan Henriquez is the big man in the middle. For Texas Tech, they're 2-6 in Big 12 play. Josh Gray, the talented freshman point guard. Dusty Hanna's one of the best-kept secrets in the Big 12. A beautiful stroke from the outside. Jamal Williams, Jay Crockett, and Jordan Tolbert round out the starting five for Chris Walker. Chris Walker has done a nice job, Stephen Howard. No question about it. He wants the full-time job. He wants that interim tag taken off his label.
Yeah, he's done an exceptional job. You think about how he got this team 8 days before the season started, and what he's been able to do with this basketball team, truly amazing. And I think he's earned the job.
And Bruce Weber, this week, he complimented Frank Martin, the old coach, on the players that were left behind. And he said, these guys are good. They play with tenacity in a defensive end. He's made a few tweaks. What a good job Bruce Weber has done in his first year at Kansas State.
Well, I would think he would want to commend Frank Martin, returning 86% of the scoring.
There's Rodney Magruder, the go-to guy for the Wildcats. Should be on the All-Big 12 first team at the end of the season. A mild-mannered competitor. And you look at our officiating crew, veteran officiating crew, Tom Eads, Dave Hall, and Randy Heimerman.
Now that it started this game, Doug, is going to be very important for Texas Tech. They're going to need to make sure they're going to withstand that first hit in the mouth that the Wildcats are going to throw at them.
Rodriguez with the basketball, pulls it out. And Magruder coming off that screen will take the first shot tonight, and he will go to the line and shoot two. Jay Crockett gets his first foul of the night for the Red Raiders.
You know, it's really interesting with Jay Crockett starting. He doesn't like to start, Doug, and feels somewhat superstitious about it. The worst game that he's had all year was the one that he started. So, interesting move by Coach Chris Walker to start Jay Crockett at the beginning of this game.
Big12Sports.com. As you look at Chris Walker, I talked about the great shooters in the league this year. Steven, you ought to read it. Top eight guys who shoot the rock in the Big 12, and Roddy McGruber was one of my top eight.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, he's a guy that once the lights come on, he finds a way to manufacture points. The bigger the game, the better that he plays.
Dusty Hannes, who has the basketball, also on that list. A rare drive to the basket, and he gets fouled.
And you notice the way Dusty Hannes did not have any type of open look once he came off that stagger double from the baseline. And Kansas State worked on that during shoot-around this morning. Wanted to make sure that he did not have a clear line of sight. They want him to put the ball on the ground like he just did in that play.
Will Spradling gets his first foul for K-State. And Hannes is now 10 for 10 in the season. Hasn't gone to the line that often. But 100% is pretty darn good for the freshman out of Little Rock, Arkansas.
Oh, his first miss. What the follow. Jordan Tolbert.
And nothing, Doug, nothing will upset a coach more than not boxing out on a free throw and to allow a tip dunk. That's something that you don't see much in college basketball at any level.
From the corner, back iron, Shane Southwell, but the offensive rebound, new shot clock, and inside. And the foul on Jordan Henriquez. He'll shoot two.
Now, Doug, take a look at this. Absolutely zero blockout, and Tolbert just goes around Jordan Henriquez. You got to put a body on an athletic player like that, and from the beginning of this game, that could be the play of the game. That's a tremendous display of athleticism by Jordan Tolbert.
Henriquez, only a 29% shooter from the free throw line. Has a very nice stroke. You're an old lefty.
Oh, yeah.
I appreciate that.
Very adept at the free throw line, but that was not a bad idea fouling Jordan Henriquez. He's a guy that when he scores early, he gets engaged for the whole game. So not allowing him to score early from a field goal and making him earn it from the charity stripe, smart play by the Red Raiders.
Rodriguez hassling Josh Gray. Got a report on hand, is staying his face. And Tolbert gets by Henriquez going up. First foul, the big man, Jordan Henriquez.
Great job getting Tolbert the basketball down low, and they feel like against Henriquez, he can use his quickness and athleticism to go around him, initiate body contact, and that was a great play by Tolbert of drawing that contact and causing the foul.
Notice Tolbert today at the shoot-around, a young man who doesn't bounce it when he gets the ball, just grabs it and shoots. A little unusual. Usually have a few bounces and maneuvers at the free throw line. He just takes and shoots.
Actually, that's the better way to go about shooting the free throw, because it doesn't allow you to get off balance, off rhythm. And he just gets it, goes up straight in perfect motion. And I love his stroke at the charity stripe.
Four-guard lineup for Kansas State, a lot of motion.
They miss Henriquez wide open on that flash to the baseline. Good defense early on by Texas Tech.
They screen away from the basketball.
Now it's the last 9 seconds that Kansas State gets you with that motion offense.
Rodriguez, tough shot. Still had time with 8 on the shot clock.
And Rodriguez has really been struggling scoring. It hadn't affected his ability to play defense or run the team, but that's a smart play by Texas Tech, forcing Angel Rodriguez to shoot the jumper.
Kravic inside with the left hand, won't go. Here comes Southwell. Looking for Magruder, up and under, well done.
You know, Shane Southwell is arguably the best passer on Kansas State. You saw his ability as that stretch forward to take that full fast break and dime it to his teammate for a nice fast break transition point.
Gray out to Hannes, who's just itching to fire. But again, the scouting report today, don't let Hannes beat you. Don't give him a wide open look. The lob inside, and Magruder gets called for the foul. Backing in to Dejan Kravic.
Now watching that last play by Shane Southwell, watch him hit the basketball and immediately look up and start running. Nice crossover at half court, avoids the defender, and able to see Josh Gray biting on the fake. Magruder smartly goes right rim to the rim, catches the basketball, and that was a very efficient fast break, straight line by Shane Southwell. And you see what's so important about him since he's been instituted into the starting lineup.
Todrick Gotcher has checked in for Texas Tech, and now a foul whistle on Shane Southwell with a hold before the ball came inbounds, had the jersey of Jay Crockett. Already 14 fouls against the Wildcats. Shane Southwell almost got a steal.
And right there you saw the activity by Kansas State, and Dusty Hannes almost threw it directly to Kansas State, what Chris Rocker calls color blindness of his players at times, throwing it to the opposition. You got to be more careful with your passes against Kansas State, one of the best defensive teams in the Big 12.
Gray with the left hand. That ball was blocked and stolen by Shane Southwell. K-State leads the Big 12 in steals. Scrabbling from three-point range. Good-looking stroke by number 55.
And with that last play by Josh Gray, you see his ability to get past the defense, but once he gets past that first line of defense, he's not able to make an efficient pass with the turnover, and Kansas State able to turn that into a scoring transition play.
Wildcats with their first lead. Bruce Weber drew the team together at the end of the shoot-around today and really emphasized the point, guys. We got to come out with energy. We have to set the tone early. They want to fall into a trap here in Lubbock. Nice ball movement, and Kravic with the easy two.
Well, he wanted to make sure they didn't look ahead to the game on Monday against Kansas and let this team know that, like, look, if you lose to Texas Tech, the game against Iowa State, the game against Kansas will not mean anything.
Thomas Gibson now in the game and with the basketball for the Wildcats. Magruder. Bradley. Gibson, another lefty. Off the glass, no less. Awkward angle, but it looked good.
Gibson does a great job of using his body to create space. And you see him just backing Kravic down into the post and then going off the glass efficiently, scoring down on the post.
And is with that ball fake, and the Wildcats have yet to bite on that. And there's the turnover. Again, Texas Tech leads the Big 12 in turnovers, 16 and a half a game. One more look. Gray with a dish. Texas Tech down by only two. Here in Lubbock, Texas, it's 13th-ranked Kansas State on top, 9-7. And remember, Kansas City's inaugural Big 12 5K Fun Run and Family Stroll happening in conjunction with the Phillips 66 Big 12 Basketball Championship, Saturday, March 16th, 9 a.m., downtown Kansas City. The winner of the men and women's divisions will each get $1,000 of Phillips 66 gasoline. And hopefully the weather is going to be fantastic, and hopefully I can talk some of the guys on the team, Dave Armstrong and Reed Geddes, maybe even Mitch Holtzison, to run in that race with me on that Saturday morning, Stephen.
You're going to run that?
It's only 3 miles. Come on.
Only 3 miles.
3.1 to be exact.
Oh, that. See, 3 miles I can do. 3.1, no chance.
We'll be out there in full force, the Big 12 Network team. As you look at Chris Walker wearing the glasses tonight, his enthusiasm is infectious. There's no doubt about it. When you talk to him, you really believe when he says, I'm going to turn this thing around in just a matter of a year or two. He's got a plan, and he thinks he is the right guy to get the job.
Well, it's one thing if he believes, but he's got this team buying into his program, and they believe. His practice yesterday was one of the most energetic that I've seen this year in all of Big 12 teams that I've watched.
And again, the officials calling it tied here early on.
Five, Josh Gray.
Josh Gray gets called for his second foul of the night.
And one thing about Texas Tech is they will pack it in on the inside, and Coach Bruce Weber was wary of that, knowing that they want to make this defense go side to side and use the passing of the motion offense to get their easy looks.
Thomas Gibson, the inbounds play, works to perfection. And again, the Red Raiders worked on that inbounds play. Just a few hours ago, they went over that and over that. Oops.
See Tolbert down low against Gibson, working for position down on the block.
Jay Crockett. Daylon Robinson is in at the point now for Texas Tech. Josh Gray on the bench with those two fouls. About 14 and a half minutes to play in this first half. Rodney Magruder. Well, you can hear that. That slap from over here. That foul's on Crockett.
Taking a look at this last play down on the other end, a great curl, and then the pass to Jay Crockett attacking the basket. And he's one of the top six men, Doug, in the country, and his ability to score and rebound is essential for Texas Tech and their ability to win basketball games.
Rodney Magruder just goes about his business, effective each and every night for Kansas State. Young man from the Washington, D.C. area. Frank Martin signed several players from that hotbed of basketball talent. He came to Manhattan and has gotten better each and every year.
What I like about him, and he's even improved during Big 12 play. He's averaging 5 more points per game and almost 10 percentage points higher in field goals percentage in the last 12 games. And when you can elevate your game against the elevated competition, that just shows the concentration and focus of a player.
Nino Williams is in the game now for Kansas State, his first action of the night. Shane Southwell gets a rest. Look at the field goal shooting. Good for both teams.
And that's really important for Texas Tech, who's really struggled to score in Big 12 conference play. Getting confidence early is huge for them down the stretch.
Gocher with a miss, and here come the Wildcats.
And that was just good defense by Kansas State, forcing Gocher into a horrible shot at the free throw line.
Martavius Irving is in the game now for Kansas State. Wildcats get great production from their bench, and a foul on the screen. That goes against Thomas Gibson.
And this is when mass meets non-mass.
Wow.
Ty Nurse might actually need a nurse after Thomas Gibson laid the wood on him on that screen.
Coach Schneider liked that maneuver.
Yeah.
Because Thomas Gibson is built like a big defensive tackle. Robinson gets held up by Irving. And again, our officiating crew calling it very tight here in the early going. That's 16 fouls on the Wildcats.
And Texas Tech needs to find a way to get the basketball to Tolbert on the block. He's got good position on Gibson, and he has the quickness on Gibson. They have to use that advantage against him down low.
Robinson, a little twisting move. It appeared that he got away with a travel.
Not only that, but he spun into the man.
Gibson more comfortable on the other side of the basket. The lefty with the turnover. Kravic is very active inside. Now, I just get the feeling the Red Raiders ought to get the big guy the ball. A few more touches. He wants it right now, and there it is.
Well, that's what Coach Weber was afraid of, them utilizing their bigs, because Tolbert and Kravic, they just get on to that nice jump hook off the left shoulder by Kravic.
3 weeks ago, talked to this young man at practice in Norman, Oklahoma, and then he had a fine game against the Sooners. I'm impressed by Kravic. Goes with both hands inside, Steven.
Well, he's a work in progress, young man out of Canada, and he's only going to get better, but they want him to use those shoulders, be a little bit more physical down on the block.
Irving from three-point range delivers.
In that play, you just saw the beauty of their motion offense. The ball never dies in anyone's hands. It goes quickly from player to player. And when you're open, you just knock it down.
Look at the three-point field goals. Texas Tech has yet to shoot one from behind the arc. As the shot clock winds down to five.
That's just great defense by Kansas State.
Robinson throws up a flare. And here comes Spradlin looking to push it. Magruder. Strong move inside.
And that's one of the things that Rodney Magruder has to his game, the ability to put it on the bounce, get into the teeth of the defense. You saw him get in the paint and just elevate over the defender, and that's just too low, too easy for Rodney Magruder.
Gibson, banging with Tolbert. Nurse, just a free throw from 15 feet. And again, here come the Wildcats.
Right now is where you see the talent disparity between Kansas State and Texas Tech.
Robinson gets called for the body check. Stay with their biggest lead of the night, 18-11 here in Lubbock. Back here in Lubbock, Texas, Kansas State on top by 7, and Rodney Magruder leads the Wildcats with 6 points.
Yeah, and this is the sixth best score in the Big 12, and so you got to keep a body on Rodney Magruder at all time and have that Magruder awareness and allow him to drive into the lane, elevate over the defense. You have to have the defense converge and make the rest of Kansas State defeat you, because Rodney Magruder has done this time and time again throughout his career for the Wildcats.
And he gets a breather, put in a new stick of gum there as he gets his first action on the bench tonight. Good start for the senior. At Kansas State, off to a blistering start. That's a rare miss and a nice offensive board by DJ Johnson.
And really, this is the danger zone for Texas Tech. They're down 7, and you can't get too far behind, because you got to remember, this is the best scoring defense in the Big 12 at Kansas State. They're not going to allow you to score a lot of baskets consecutively throughout this game.
Southwell says, why not? Perhaps Kravic gave him a little too much room there.
Well, he really had to, because Southwell is one of those stretch fours that can put the ball on the bounce, and Kravic knew that he could take him, but that's what Southwell does so well, is he takes good, efficient shots and doesn't get out of his lane.
Kravic with a miss. And the Wildcats
pick up another loose ball. One and out again for the Red Raiders. Kravic gets the miss that time. Southwell, his eyes lit up again, had that open shot.
Well, you hit one on him, and he figured he played that point forward role and was able to take him again. But that was a possession that Coach Bruce Weber wanted him to touch a little bit more hands than just him bringing it up and taking a jump shot.
Shane Southwell, his first foul. As you look at Bruce Weber, enjoyed talking to Coach Weber today. And also reminiscing, you see behind Coach Weber, Wayne McClain on the left side of the screen there. Worked in Peoria, Illinois many years ago, and Wayne McClain was a great high school coach at Peoria Manual High School.
Actually coached my former teammate at DePaul, David Moot. Actually sent me a text message to tell him hi.
Coach McClain has been around the game a long time. Coach Weber, that's Chris Lowry, who had a fine couple of seasons at Southern Illinois.
Was a good player at Southern Illinois. Mm-hmm. I remember battling him many a time.
So nice staff for Bruce Weber. And Coach Weber told us today, asking what the difference was in the Big 12 and the Big 10. He said, better athletes, more of them here in the Big 12.
Yeah, he mentioned, you know, you get a couple in the Big 10, you get an occasional Oladipo, but you got a lot of the Oladipos in the Big 12.
Josh Gray now back in with those two fouls. Remember, about the 15 and a half minute mark, went to the bench. Tolbert bangs inside.
And see, that's where you see the Josh Gray that gets people at Texas Tech excited, able to penetrate the defense and then dime it to Tolbert. But it's that decision making once he gets in the lane that at times has not been there. Good defense by Texas Tech.
Irving got that screen. Nino with the offensive rebound, and Rodriguez wide open.
Angel Rodriguez,
biggest lead of the night for Kansas State. Double digits.
And you're seeing right there that the ability to get those second chance points by Kansas State, the best rebounding team in the Big 12. They get 54% of all available rebounds, and they showed it in that play, getting a second chance opportunity.
Kansas State dominating on the glass.
And really, Doug, those rebounds are really the toughness stats that Kansas State gets in. Here you're seeing that blow-by ability of Josh Gray. He gets into the teeth of the defense, and then when the defense converges, he passes it to Tolbert, who was able to lay it up with strength. And those are the type of plays that Texas Tech are going to need, but more importantly, they're going to need stops on the defensive end, Doug.
Angel Rodriguez, second-year man. He looks very comfortable running the show for the 15th ranked team in the country. And he's hit two in a row now from three-point range.
Well, I really think that's been one of the things for Kansas State, was the ability of Angel Rodriguez to run this basketball team. This is a guy that's feelers. And against Oklahoma, when he drove in the lane and initiated contact with those free throws, that was huge for this team, but huge for the confidence of Angel Rodriguez.
So the crowd now on their feet. Clark Lambert has checked in for the Red Raiders. Doesn't get a lot of playing time.
The big thing for Texas Tech is to keep this within 10 points.
Wildcats being very patient on the offensive end. Veteran club that was rejected by Kravic. And Gray, he'll take off. Excellent for Texas Tech.
Well, Kravic is seventh in the Big 12 in block shots at 1.4, and they were able to use that block shot to initiate their transition offense. And Gray just did a good job of taking it coast to coast for the bucket. They're going to need a lot more of those possessions.
Rodriguez going for three in a row. Josh Gray looks over at the bench. Chris Walker marks out the set that he wants. Lambert hit that first three for Texas Tech. Hannes was going for two, but that was partially blocked.
And that was a good defense. They know a lot of their stagger singles turn into flares for Hannes, and they were on that the whole time.
That foul will go against Cam State. Check out Josh Gray, just a freshman. So quick. 8-point cushion. Back after this. 26-18, Kansas State leading the Red Raiders. Doug Bell and Stephen Howard. Our quick stats now provided by La Quinta Inns. Good shooting for both teams, Stephen.
Yeah, it is. Exceptional shooting. The biggest discrepancy is in that rebound with Kansas State plus 6 in the rebound total. And when you're on the road, you want to make sure that you have the effort and those physicality stats of Kansas State from the jump tonight. Been doing exceptionally well in that regard.
Clark Lambert came off the bench and nailed that 3-point shot. First one of the night for the Red Raiders, and now has 4 points off the bench. Student section behind the hoop. They love this kid from San Antonio. He has a good shot.
No, he really does. And you can see a lot of confidence from him from the free throw line. Talking to Chris Walker, he said he was going to go 12 deep today, playing all players, really trying to use that bench tonight to try to tire down Kansas State a little bit.
And it keeps everyone happy. You practice hard, you're going to get some playing time. Spradlin. And Gibson with a follow. Big man, nobody blocked him out.
That's where you see that offensive rebounding prowess of Kansas State, one of the better offensive rebounding teams in the country. Got to keep a body on the Wildcats once that shot goes up.
Hannes has yet to get a 3-point shot off.
When you see, Doug, Texas Tech is waiting until about 15 seconds before they initiate their offense. And they're running with a short clock each time down.
That ball looked like it grazed off Gibson out of bounds, but nevertheless, it is the Wildcats basketball. Luke Adams has checked in now for Texas Tech.
And that's the crowd favorite.
Lately, Luke Adams, a young man who just will bust a gut out there. He really gives it all he has.
And that's what you look for, Doug, from your bench players, guys that give it all in practice and really throw it out on the line for your team.
Rodney Magruder coming off those screens. Moves so well without the basketball. Good hustle on both teams, but here comes Texas Tech.
And this is where they need to get Tolbert the basketball down on the block, particularly when he's got Nino Williams. He's got the quickness ability on him, more physical. He should be able to take advantage.
And that foul will go against Nino Williams. That's the ninth team foul against Kansas State.
You know, if I'm the Red Raiders, I'm going to get a steady diet of Jordan Tolbert down on the block for these last 4 minutes and 44 seconds.
Adrian Diaz now checks in for Kansas State. Bruce Weber going deep on his bench, mainly because of foul issues, now 19 fouls.
You know, Jordan Tolbert really turned the corner. Had a rough beginning of the season as his father passed away 2 weeks into the season. Then all the things that went on with Coach Gillespie, and he really went into a shell. And, you know, talking to Coach Walker, he's really turned the corner, playing a lot better with a lot of confidence now into the conference.
So the Wildcats had that 10-point lead, but Texas Tech now on a 9-2 run over the last 3-plus minutes. Luke Adams is a pest on defense, up in the face of Rodriguez. There's Magruder coming off the double screen. And Gibson gets the ball stripped away, but then gets it back. The big man with quick hands, like a boxer in there.
Yeah, and you saw Magruder running the baseline, much like you see a lot of two guards in the NBA, like Reggie Williams, going side to side. Great recovered defense by Tech, able to force the miss, but again, that second chance opportunities by Kansas State is really killing the Red Raiders down the stretch.
That foul goes against Will Spradlin. So the Red Raiders will shoot two during the double bonus. Coming up, we'll get you up to speed on what's happening in the Big 12. That's next from Lubbock. Kansas State on top, 30-22 here in Lubbock. Kansas State getting a bit of foul trouble now, 10 team fouls, as we get you up to speed on what's happening in the Big 12. Lots happening, especially at Oklahoma State. Marcus Smart is the player of the week. What a week he had, hitting the game winner against Iowa State at home, and then so big last Saturday in that upset win in Lawrence. Will Clyburn was the rookie of the week for the second consecutive week, and the Cowboys ended Kansas's 33-game home winning streak. In fact, the first time Oklahoma State had beaten a top-five team on the road since Eddie Sutton wore the Oklahoma State uniform and played for Coach Iva.
Yeah, it was a good and a bad thing. Great for Oklahoma State, able to go in there and win at Fog Allen Fieldhouse, but you got to believe that Kansas is not going to let another team go in there this year and come out with a victory in Lawrence, Kansas.
So the miss at the free throw line for Gocher. Freshman talking to himself. And he'll go to the bench again. Jamal Williams now back in for the Red Raiders as Chris Walker just continues to work that bench. Going to play all 12 players tonight and has already in this first half.
Really like the energy, particularly on the defensive end, by Texas Tech thus far in this basketball game. That is the only way they're going to be able to come out with a victory tonight.
That was partially blocked. Rodriguez thought he got hit on the elbow. In fact, he's talking to Randy Heimerman. Cats will take it out of bounds underneath their hoop after the foul. Magruder gets a strip. Rodriguez gets it right back.
And that's what I love about Angel Rodriguez. He's everywhere on this basketball court for Kansas State.
Jordan Henriquez pulled down that rebound, and the ball got stripped, and now Magruder will go to the line for two.
And even though Jordan Henriquez did not come up with this basketball, his ability to keep it alive and allow his teammate Rodney Magruder to go up strong with it, that's what helps Kansas State when you have an active Jordan Henriquez. And you saw him from the beginning of the game, sat on the bench for a little while, but he's come in and reacclimated himself, put his imprint on this game.
Clark Lammer got his first foul, swiping the hand of Rodney Magruder. He will now try to push it out again to a 9-point lead. Luke Adams better be careful because Rodriguez is zeroing in for a steal.
See, this is where Jordan Tolbert has to attack Henriquez. Now the good play by Clark Lambert, just tapped the ball out. His teammate. Sometimes you don't have to grab it.
Luke Adams from deep, and that gets the crowd on their feet. Luke Adams with valuable minutes for the Red Raiders. Rodriguez with a turnover.
Got numbers.
Tolbert with a follow. It's a 3-point game. Timeout, Kansas State. Big Mo has shifted the way of the Red Raiders.
Well, this is right where the Red Raiders want to be. You see the last play and just a patient Red Raider offense working the ball around. Luke Adams with Angel Rodriguez into his face, jumps up in rhythm, and then a great fast break. Jamal Williams might have got away with the offensive push-off, but his teammate Jordan Tolbert going up, getting the offensive second chance opportunity, going up strong to get this crowd on their feet and get the momentum squarely with Texas Tech.
Red Raiders just playing with more desire right now. They're going after loose basketballs, getting a lot of strips, and that's usually Kansas State's game.
Well, when you're first to the fourth, first to the 50-50 balls, you see Jordan Tolbert with 10 points in the first half. And for me, that is a huge key for this game. Get him involved. Get him on the low post, because that's where they can use, that's really their only advantage in this game, is Jordan Tolbert on the block for the Red Raiders.
Tolbert all smiles. Really a likable guy. And when you watch the practice that Chris Walker runs, and you were here last night, positive energy. Didn't see it last year, frankly, under Coach Gillespie.
No, you didn't. And, you know, look at Tolbert the last four games. He's averaged 12.5 points, 6.5 rebounds. So he's been a hot guy for the Raiders in those last four games.
Dusty Hannes called for the foul. Holding Spradling.
Now, it's important for Dusty Hannes to stay in this basketball. He's really the only outside threat for Texas Tech. They shoot 27% from three. That's the worst in the Big 12. So they need him on the court.
Spradling is an 86% shooter from the free throw line.
Yeah, he's not going to miss those, Doug.
Boy, great form for this second-year man who is so quiet on the court and quietly puts up impressive numbers.
He's a coach's son, and he plays with the poise of a coach's son. I mean, he's been there, done that. He's heard it all. And so that's what you want from your quarterback on the court.
Got that loose rim here in Lubbock, and the microphone is right there.
You see Coach Weber wants to go at Luke Adams and double-team him and try to get the ball out of his hands and create a turnover.
Offensive foul inside goes against DJ Johnson. He hustled down to get on the blocks where he's comfortable, but got his body into the defender.
What you're seeing now, Doug, is Kansas State is reacting to Texas Tech. And when your team and you're the more aggressive team and you're seeing that with Texas Tech, you're able to dictate the pace and the tempo, and that bodes favorably for the Red Raiders.
And another foul against DJ Johnson. That was a foul. He reacted like he couldn't believe it. Got him with the body.
You've seen Lambert just using his quickness, going past him, and yeah, you got him with the body. They're going to call that every single time. That was really smart by Clark Lambert, knowing that he can get past him and really just initiating that body contact once he did.
Two quick fouls on DJ Johnson and Lambert. Pulls Texas Tech within four as Jordan Henriquez comes back in.
Really what was key for me is to keep this game within striking distance going into halftime. 10 points, but the position that the Red Raiders are right now, I know Coach Chris Walker has to be ecstatic.
Lambert threw up the air ball. Just didn't get a good grip on that one.
Yeah, okay, I'll go with that explanation.
It looked great until it came up about a foot shy.
You know, that's just a lack of concentration. When you shoot free throws, you'd rather be long than short to give you an opportunity to offensive rebound.
Knocks it down. That's just a two. He was inside the black stripe. And Irving looking for the steal on Adams. And coming up at halftime, on the Phillips 66 halftime report, we'll tell you about the player of the week in the conference, classroom champion, all the highlights and stats, so don't go anywhere. That's the Phillips 66 halftime report. Look at it. Clark Lambert go to the bench, along with Kravic, and I tell you, Chris Walker, he is substitute happy right now.
Well, he's doing a great job of getting his guys in and out, getting them a little bit of breather, and then putting them in while they're fresh. And he's got his starters in now for this last 1 minute and 20 seconds.
Pocket for three. And a strip by Gray, and it goes out of bounds. So it'll be Kansas State basketball.
See, that's one of the things that Crockett is fell in love a little bit with, the outside shot, partly because of the physicality in Big 12 play. He's better for this team when he attacks the rim and uses that athleticism to create and initiate contacts and manufacture points.
Luke Adams now back in for Josh Gray. Remember, Gray has two fouls, so he'll sit the final 60-plus seconds.
Crockett has two fouls as well. That's why he got out of the game.
rattling with a crossover dribble, knocks down the jump shot, back up to an 8-point lead.
I just love the poise of Spradling. I mean, he gets in the paint, the game is just in slow motion for him. Notice the hard hedge by Kansas State, really forcing the Red Raiders out towards the half court line.
Timeout, Red Raiders.
And Chris Walker calls timeout with 18 on the shot clock. Just under 39 seconds on the game clock. Chris Walker, a guy who has certainly paid his dues. He was an assistant coach, Loyola Marymount, Vanderbilt, Pepperdine, UMass, New Mexico, twice at Villanova. He was an assistant at Texas Tech before he got the interim job. He's been around.
No, he has. Played at Villanova, part of two NCAAs, two NITs, 96 starts as a point guard, so he knows what it takes to win both as a player and as a coach.
Look at Luke Adams in the middle of the huddle. Kid looks tired. He's giving it all he's got. Hey, remember Big12Sports.com/CTV and check out the Big 12 Network announcer block covering the baseline. This week, I talk about the top eight clutch shooters in the Big 12. Check it out. And also talk about some of the guys who no longer play, but they can still shoot it. Fred Hoiberg, last week at practice, the mayor can still shoot the rock.
Oh, yeah.
I'd bet on him in a horse game any day of the week.
You definitely would bet on him on a free throw game. He's always in there every year with the coach's free throw challenge.
He is tough. The big time stuff.
Yeah, that was a great offensive sequence by Texas Tech, even though they didn't come up with the score. Got a second chance opportunity, got the shot that they wanted from the perimeter. And really, Texas Tech has shown that this half, they can get the shot that they want and they can get the stop that they want.
Spradlin looks up at the clock. Tried to get the defender up in the air.
Great defense by Texas Tech.
They wouldn't budge, so Kansas State, number 13 in the country, with a lead. But Jordan Tolbert leads all scorers with 10 points. Perfect from the field. An entertaining first half. Chris Walker's played everybody on his team. And the Red Raiders hanging in against the Wildcats. Watching some of that coverage tomorrow on ESPNU, as you look at Josh Gray. A young man from Louisiana who originally signed with Mississippi State, and when Rick Stansberry retired, he didn't want to play there. And quickly signed with Texas Tech.
Not only that, though, but Kansas State was in the running for him, so Coach Walker was telling him down the stretch, hey, these guys recruited you. You should be able to get up for this.
Jordan Tolbert led all scorers with 10 points in that first half. Josh Gray doesn't go to his left very often. The lob inside to Crockett. Nurse from the outside gets that to go home. Mini fist up for Ty Nurse.
You know, Ty Nurse has been struggling from distance this year, only shooting 18%, but he was the guy for them from distance last year and showed a lot of confidence now getting back into the fold, but they need a confident Ty Nurse down the stretch for them to do well against the Wildcats.
7 for 35 on the season. Ty Nurse. And the slam by Crockett. And the crowd is on their feet, down by only three.
And that was just great hands by the Red Raiders. Active hands affecting the basketball, getting in there, and Crockett coast-to-coast steal and the transition point.
Rodney Magruder. From the corner.
That was great ball movement, Doug. You see that ball touched multiple hands and then went to the wide open Angel Rodriguez on the baseline for the jumper.
He's 3 of 5 from behind the stripe, Rodriguez. Tolbert had that tremendous first half, up and under.
And I'd like to see Tolbert go immediately when he gets the basketball and not wait for the defense to settle in.
And a foul inside. Against Texas Tech.
And look at the active hands by Crockett. Just getting in there, and Tolbert had a hand in there as well. And then Kravic just took it coast to coast, didn't see any defense around him, and got the crowd involved. And I know Chris Walker could not have envisioned a better start for his Red Raiders in the second half.
That last foul was whistled against Jordan Tolbert, his first, and Magruder with the left hand. He wanted the and one, but did not get the whistle. Gray, left hand off the glass.
Horrible defense by the Wildcats. I know Bruce Weber cannot be excited about that. Can't let a guy go coast to coast 94 feet unhindered for a layup with his bad hand.
Here comes a steal by the Red Raiders. Let's see if it turns into points. Again, the scouting report, if you go to practice, they'll tell you Gray does not like to go to that left hand.
Well, not only that, he just has not made great decisions once he got past the teeth of the defense. He's got 21 assists and 25 turnovers. That's negative in the assist-to-turnover ratio. He's going to have to get a lot better at that if he wants to quarterback a Big 12 team.
Nurse looks up at the shot clock. And the miss. It has been a tough year for Ty Nurse from behind the arc, even though he did hit that one a moment ago.
A tough year for Texas Tech from beyond the arc, shooting Big 12 worst 27%. So they don't get a lot of points. They average about a little under 5 threes per game.
Thomas Gibson. He's backing him in. Misses the gimme, but gets the offensive rebound.
And really, that's the only way Thomas Gibson can score. It's with angles, using that body. And the Red Raiders did a good job of getting in front of him, making it difficult for him to get to the rim.
Kravic now back in for Texas Tech. Gocher is back in. Dusty Hanna is back in for the Red Raiders as Chris Walker just continues to go to that merry-go-round on the bench.
And what he's doing, he's keeping them fresh. And you see with the hand on the ball by Kravic, it's working to the Red Raiders' benefit.
Wildcats basketball. The scrum on the floor, so they'll wipe up the sweat on the hardwood.
And this was all initiated by Kravic getting that deflection. And a lot of times you don't have to come up with the steal, just the ability to deflect the ball and allow your teammate to come with it. That's all you need for a great defensive team.
Gray comes up with a steal, puts the pocket to Irving through the legs. Oh, what a nice play, Josh Gray.
And really what's impressing me most in this second half is the defensive prowess about Texas Tech. You see 5 steals. Texas Tech leads the Big 12 with 8.7 steals per game, and they're really active and energized on the defensive end in this second half.
Southwell was looking for Gibson, and now Gibson will set that big body screen. That's not exactly how you do the pick and roll. Gibson should have rolled a little quicker, Steven.
I think there's much about Gibson's game that has quicker in it. He's the force, the power guy. Great rebound by Crockett. Defense does not stop on the defensive end until you get that defensive rebound. Tech doing a better job in the second half in that regard.
Not a huge crowd here in Lubbock, but the folks that are here are into the game, especially the student section. And Chris Walker hates that. One turnover in the first half, and that was a bad turnover. Check out Josh Gray. What a steal and the finish. And we're back after this message from your friends at Phillips 66. Red Raiders on a mini run here in the start of the second half, down by only 4. Bruce Weber knows how big this game is. And check out the coach. Oh, yeah. That clipboard, I think that's broken.
Well, and that's what Coach Weber was telling his team during shoot-around this morning. Look, this team beat Iowa State. They played with Kansas the whole game. They were in the game with West Virginia with 6 minutes left to go in the game. It just was a couple possessions. And here you see the steals, the active hands by Texas Tech. Josh Gray, Jay Crockett, Tolbert had their hands in there. And Josh Gray just picked this the whole way long. He saw it. He felt it. He took it. And he took it coast to coast for the nice lay-in by the Red Raiders.
The lob to Gibson. Banging inside, that was blocked by Gocher, but he is fouled now by Gocher.
Foul number 20, Patrick Gilcher.
Steals tonight with five. Again, they lead the Big 12. Kansas State leads the Big 12 in scoring defense, allowing just under 58 points a game. That is outstanding as Gibson now tries to make the Red Raiders pay, and he misses the first.
And really, that's the scrappiness of the Red Raiders. Talent-wise, they know they don't have the same type of talent of your Kansas or even of your K-State. They have to beat you with effort, with energy, being active on the defensive end.
Five-point lead for Kansas State, 13th in the country in the AP poll, 15th in the ESPN coaches poll. We're live in Lubbock, Texas, United Spirit Arena. Doug Bell and former DePaul great Stephen Howard. His gorgeous basketball facility.
Notice Kansas State hedging really hard on the pick and roll of Texas Tech, and they worked on that all practice long.
Tolbert, little jump hook. Boy, did everything but go down. That looked like Phil Mickelson's putt when he was going for 59 the other day. Did everything but go down.
Coach Walker is happy with that play, even though they didn't come up with the bucket. As long as they get good looks at the basket.
Southwell won't go, and Gocher inside. That has to be a shove from behind. Actually, the foul goes against Rodney Magruder, so there was some pushing and shoving going on both ends, and Magruder didn't like the call, and I didn't see it, frankly. I thought it went against Gocher.
Yeah, that's a tough call. Looked like Magruder was just going up in the air, and Gocher had his body on Magruder. I don't know if I agree with that call.
Tolbert very active, and there's a turnover. So one turnover in the first half, now two in the second half for Kansas or Texas Tech.
And really, you saw right there a great slip by Jordan Tolbert, wide open to the basket. Jamal Williams just tried to hit a Jay Crockett that wasn't ready for the basketball.
Turnovers now. Kansas State with seven, and as we mentioned, Texas Tech well below their season average, almost 16 a game.
And really, Kansas State is number 18th in the country at assist to turnover ratio, so them getting seven turnovers in the first half is not a norm.
Irving rattles the glass. They better check that. And Tolbert and Gibson banging, so that's a double foul.
And really, that's something that's been brewing all game long, going back all the way to the first half. Gibson and Tolbert just battling, and the officials just want to make sure it doesn't get elevated at all. You're going to see the ref just squarely on them, wanting to make sure that it doesn't elevate at all.
Three fouls on Gibson, so he will go to the bench, and Jordan Henriquez now back in.
Immediately Tech goes right at Henriquez.
Henriquez stood his ground that time, and now Will Spradling.
And you can tell Tolbert knew that Henriquez is seventh in the Big 12 blocking shots. Henriquez didn't even have to jump, just used his length to his advantage.
Magruder got his own rebound. Irving, line drive shot, needs a little more arc on that shot. And a travel goes against Rodney Magruder, who got knocked to the floor.
Second chance opportunities. K-State still attacking the offensive glass. The Red Raiders very fortunate that Rodney Magruder came up with a travel on that possession.
Todrick Gocher back in for Texas Tech. Dusty Hannes now checks in. Ty Nurse will replace Josh Gray.
Look to Tech to try to get it down on the baseline again for Jordan Tolbert. Did you see that rebound discrepancy? Plus 15 for Kansas State, doing an exceptional job on both ends of the floor on the glass.
The Raiders are hanging around despite that lopsided rebounding margin.
Tolbert doing the work down low. He's got Henriquez behind him. You got to give him the basketball.
Shot clock now at three. Boy, that was a tough shot, but Crockett had to fire. Irving tries again. That time the line draw shot goes down.
You know, Doug, you mentioned that shot he made off the glass, and when a player makes a shot like that, it makes him that much more confident to pull up for a three-point shot, even if he's not a three-point shooter.
Timeout for Texas Tech. It'll be a full timeout for the Red Raiders. Check out Martavius. Irving. Oh, yes. There's the answer. Kansas State starting to pull away. Here in Lubbock, Texas. 10-point lead for Kansas State. Steve and I making our annual pilgrimage to lovely Lubbock, Texas. We come here every year. It seems like a different coach every year for Texas Tech.
You're right. I mean, we've seen the both of the Knights, now Chris Walker, Gillespie.
And nobody does it quite like Chris Walker. As you look at the offensive rebounding numbers, again, Kansas State dominating now off the glass. And those second chance points have been big for the Wildcats.
And I still think they need a steady diet of either Kravic or Tolbert down on the block.
Ray, that time goes to the left side. Looked pretty good doing it against Irving.
You see he's got the talent, and they're really high on him, his ability to blow by the defenders, just his decision-making. And during this game today, he's done an exceptional job of running the Red Raiders.
Well, passed up the shot. Irving has the hot hand right now. That's good basketball right there. Good movement, getting yourself open. That's a veteran basketball team doing it well.
We see what makes Shane Southwell number four in the Big 12 field goal percentage from the three. He passed up a good shot and got a better one. Not too many players have that type of patience on the offensive end.
Well, the last six times down, it's been one and done for Texas Tech and Rodney Magruder. That's just a two-pointer. His foot was on the line. So an 11-point lead is the largest of the night. 13 points, excuse me, largest of the night for Kansas State. They're now 7 of 15 from behind the arc.
And when you can really see the talent disparity right now with K-State, and a closer look, you can see Rodney Magruder's foot squarely on that red. Not sure if the official saw that or they called it. Did they call that a three?
Call it a two.
They're on it.
Tell me this, Stephen. Kansas State, 17-4, one of the best starts in school history. They did lose to Michigan and Gonzaga. Gonzaga's beaten everybody in the
Good
Big
losses,
12.
Though. Those are good losses.
But they beat a very, very talented Florida team that has been blowing everybody out. That was a huge win for them in Kansas City.
That Florida victory is going to be the gift that keeps on giving throughout that whole season. And whenever you see Joe Lunardi, whenever they talk about bracketology, it's going to have good losses against the Zags in Michigan, but a great victory against Florida. I mean, I don't know if you could have a better victory because, as you mentioned, the BPI loves Florida, and they are an exceptional basketball team, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them in the Final Four.
Florida and Miami in the ACC. Florida, of course, in the SEC. The only undefeated teams in the six major conferences. Kravic inside. Good lob inside. And the big guy got position and made it look easy.
That was just great patience, great high-low action by Texas Tech. That was a design play by Chris Walker doing that timeout, executed to a T.
Mari Lawrence is now in for Kansas State. And that whistle inside goes against Texas Tech. That'll be against Kravic. We'll be right back after this message from your friends at Phillips 66.
Going to take a look at that last high-low play by the Red Raiders. And a great misdirection. And you're going to see right when Jordan Tolbert gets the ball right here, Kravic does the flash and gets the position over Shane Southwell. And when he does that, he has the advantage. You can either give him the basketball now, Southwell fights over it, and this is even better. Tolbert puts it perfectly right where only Kravic can get it. Kravic goes up strong, and that was a perfectly executed high-low play by the Red Raiders.
6 points off the bench for the big man from Canada, who needs to get a little stronger, but certainly has skill. Actually got a piece of that one. That was a nice defensive play against Southwell.
Well, the hardest thing for Tolbert is the fact that he's 6'7", going against 6'10", you know, Big 12 big men in this conference. And really, he's probably more of a 3-4 hybrid, but he's having a battle in there with some of the most physical, athletic bigs in the country.
Rodney Magruder back in for the Wildcats. 12 points, 6 rebounds for the senior.
Right now for Texas Tech, you need to have that same defensive intensity that they started the second half with, where they were active and energized with deflections and getting steals.
Kansas State plus 17 in rebounding. That has been the big story. Second half, when Texas Tech misses, they usually just get one opportunity. Josh Grado gets that one to rattle home. They're hanging around.
Doug, that's a play that all point guards need to have in their repertoire, the ability to get into the lane, throw up that floater to go over the defense. You don't touch anyone. You don't get a charge, and you're able to get your shot off against anybody.
And Magruder, that is a three. He now has 15 points. Looking at the three-point shooting, now 50% for the Wildcats.
Really, you're seeing with Kansas State, they are the best three-point field goal defensive team in the Big 12. And they're doing an exceptional job on a team in Texas Tech that really doesn't shoot the rock well from distance.
Jordan Henriquez.
Number 21, Jordan Henriquez. In for the Red Raiders, number 4, Ty Nurse. For number
Ty Nurse back in for the Red Raiders. For Henriquez, that's his second foul tonight.
And I think really what's important for Henriquez is just the fact that he's in the game. You see the length that he provides in the block, and that just deters so many jump shots in the lane.
And that foul will go against Omari Lawrence.
And again, here's that Henriquez effect. Just being long down on the block, Tech comes up with the second chance opportunity, and Henriquez with that length. You can't teach height, and that's something that you can't teach, that anticipation and ability to be right there in the lane protecting the rim at all times. Even though they kept, got the shot, didn't get the end one opportunity.
Josh Gibson now back in for the Wildcats. Kravic with 8 points. And he will go to the bench, and Jay Crockett now in for the Red Raiders.
And really, Doug, what Coach Walker wants is just to be within striking distance. You want to just keep this within 10, 4 or 5 minutes, and then make a push. But right now, the Red Raiders are right where they want to be late in this basketball game.
That was Bubba Jennings talking to Kravic on the bench, and Bubba has been here for a long time. Great player and an assistant coach for just about everybody.
He was telling me some war stories of when he was trying out for the Dallas Mavericks back in the day.
All up and under by Irving, who's had a big second half for Kansas State.
No, he really has, and you're looking at a guy that really isn't looked on to score, only averages 4.4 points a game. So anything above that, just icing on the cake for the Wildcats.
Tolbert. He's been quiet in the second half after 10 points in that first half.
But that's really what Jordan Tolbert has to do, use that quickness to go around Thomas Gibson. You're not going to win a fight backing him down, but you can go around him.
Bruce Weber thought Irving got slapped across the wrist, and Gibson tried to keep it alive, and he does.
Texas Tech looking a little bit tired out there. I think the physicality of the Wildcats is wearing down the Red Raiders a little bit.
Tolbert. That's his second bucket now in the second half. He now has 15 points.
You know, Doug, that's his first three-pointer of the year, and that's a shot to Chris Walker is saying, yes!
Looked pretty good on that one.
Oh, he looked like that's the shot that they were looking for. Like they were sizing that up all game long.
Looked like a clean steal, but Williams gets called for the reach. Martavius Irving, he is strong to the hole. 8-point lead for Kansas State on top by 8 with 7:02 to play. Doug Bell and Stephen Howard. And how about the senior from Fort Lauderdale, Martavius Irving? He's come on strong this second half, Stephen.
He really has, and particularly from distance, 2 for 3 from beyond the arc, and his ability to come up and shoot the ball with confidence is just big. And that's what the motion offense gives you. It gives multiple players the ability to score on the offensive end. When you have guys like Martavius Irving stepping up, making shots, that's huge for your team.
He is our sixth man of the game, brought to you by Motel 6, Martavius Irving. And a miss by Omari Lawrence. Kansas State has 4 southpaws, I believe. A lot of lefties on this roster.
And that's a recipe for a great team, Doug, let me tell you.
Coming from a great southpaw himself in the DePaul Hall of Fame, went on to play in the NBA, my partner.
Tech needs to try to initiate their offense early. They keep trying to get shots in that red part of the shot clock.
Keeping it alive is Kravic.
When that play was made by Josh Gray's ability to get into the defense, and then Kravic had no body on him because the defense had converged on Josh Gray.
Again, the Red Raiders just hanging around. Angel Rodriguez has been quiet in the second half. And Gray knocked that ball out of bounds. So it'll be 9 on the shot clock as the Wildcats bring it in from underneath their basket.
Great job by Gocher coming in there to hinder Andrew Rodriguez's process and really stand in front of him in the rim.
Southwell inside to Magruder. Yes, counted and the foul. That's 2 guys who've played a lot of basketball together.
Well, for me, Shane Southwell is the MIP, the most important player, passing it to the MVP, the most valuable player for the Wildcats, and his ability to be that point forward, the best passer for the Wildcats, and that was exhibited in that last play with a nice pass to Rodney Magruder in the paint.
So Magruder now with 18 points to lead the Wildcats. Texas Tech with 6 team fouls. So on the next foul by the Red Raiders, it'll be 1 in the bonus for Kansas State.
Really, you can't say enough about what Chris Walker has done coaching this basketball team. And his ability to get players in is I really think, the biggest boon for the Red Raiders.
And the offensive foul, the push-off called on Josh Gray. 3 fouls on Gray, player control foul, so they won't shoot. They will on the next one, perhaps.
And that's one of those mental lapses that they talk about when it comes to Josh Gray. That one needed, just blow by him. Don't let Angel Rodriguez bother you because he's baiting you into that foul.
Guard lineup for Kansas State. Terrific ball movement. And Tolbert ran into Angel Rodriguez. So that will be 1 in the bonus.
And again, this Wildcat team has returned 86% of their scoring offense. And the motion offense does not work if you don't have players that can pass the rock. You see, Magruder did a great job, but once the defense came to him, he hit Angel Rodriguez. And that's why this offense works so well.
Four fouls now on Tolbert, so he will go to the bench. Rodriguez shooting right into the student section.
And people don't realize how difficult that is, Doug, to shoot free throws with all that activity behind you. It takes an extended amount of concentration to make that work.
Still plenty of time, just under 5.5 to play here in Lubbock. A 9-point cushion. He just blows by the defender. That quick move to the right.
All he needs is a little bit more confidence, a little bit more structure on that jump shot, but he's got the athleticism.
Oh, jumped in there, nearly got the steal, and Magruder taps it out to Southwell.
Great play by Southwell, not shooting that ball. Bring it back and getting another attempt at a basket.
Gibson. The game keeps it alive. New 35 in the shot clock, and Rodriguez will bring it back out close to midcourt and set things up.
Gibson is your consummate below-the-rim player. Kravitz doing a good job of staying on his feet and not letting him get that advantage.
Magruder was open, just lost the handle. Southwell has Rodriguez wide open in the corner. Hits the side of the backboard.
That was great offense and better defense by the Red Raiders, forcing Angel Rodriguez from a difficult shot from a bad angle in the corner.
Kravic shows his jump hook.
And see, that's where Thomas Gibson has problems with tall, long-range players, and he couldn't do anything with Kravic's jump hook off over that left shoulder. Too short to affect that jump shot.
Scrambling. Comes up short, but another rebound. Again, that's been the story tonight. Kansas State has absolutely dominated. Now plus 18 in rebounds. Timeout, Bruce Weber in Kansas State.
30-second timeout, Wildcats.
Tonight's Big 12 Network game has been brought to you by Phillips 66, experts in gas since 1927. USAA, proudly serving the financial needs of the military, veterans, and their families. Whataburger, proud to serve it hot and fresh 24 hours a day. And by La Quinta Inns and Suites. Wake up on the bright side at La Quinta Inns and Suites. Back here in Lubbock, Texas, where Kansas State calls the timeout. The Red Raiders are just hanging around. They still have time, Stephen.
Yeah, and you really got to commend Coach Chris Walker. And I was talking to him this morning and his ability to recruit. And you talk about star players, and Texas Tech has not had a lot of them. And I talked to Dallas Kimball coach Snoop Jackson this morning. And next week, they've got Keith Frazier coming here, number 22 on the ESPN 100, a phenomenal high school player from Dallas who people liken to Ray Allen a little bit, but with the ability to put on the bounce like Kerry Kittles. And so bringing guys in like that, I think, is what Chris Walker brings to the table. And he wants to not get those diamonds in the rough here at Texas Tech. He wants to bring those diamonds in. And so I think his ability to bring those type of players in speaks a lot to his ability to bring Texas Tech back into the fold as a power in the Big 12.
He has played everybody on the roster tonight. Open. And a whistle inside goes against Crockett. Three fouls on Jay Crockett. We'll be right back. 3:19 to play. Kansas State vying for their 18th victory of the season and go 7-2 in Big 12 play. Rodney Magruder, the senior, on Another outstanding night. He is so smooth.
He's Mr. Blue Collar for a team that exemplifies being blue collar. You see him doing it every which way, showcasing his full repertoire of offensive moves inside, outside, being patient with the offense, using this motion offense to his benefit. You got to credit the team finding Rodney Magruder in positions where he can be effective. And this was a great team aspect. Rodney Magruder scores because of his teammates.
And he is our Geico player of the game, Rodney Magruder. 18 points, 7 boards. Very consistent and has been for many years now at Kansas State.
He just does it in an efficient manner. There's no wasted motions with him, no wasted shots.
Good Raiders, Josh Gray somehow got that pass to Tolbert, and Crockett loses it out of bounds.
Look at the Red Raiders now. They're not giving up at all. They're going after every loose ball. There is no give up. A lot of fight left in the Red Raiders. You got to commend Chris Walker the way that he's coached up this basketball team to really play with one of the better Big 12 teams this year.
1 minute into the second half, they trail by only 3. And then 4 minutes gone in the second half, they trail by only 4. And then with 6 minutes to play, it was a 6-point game. So they have hung around against the 13th ranked team in the country. Give them credit.
Yeah, and you look at the skill disparity for Texas Tech and Kansas State, and that's what Chris Walker talks about. You just need one piece to come in here, and it will make all things worthwhile, and other players will follow. But you got to start on the recruiting trail.
Rodriguez to Gibson, who gets that to fall. Kravic with a foul.
And that's all Angel Rodriguez. Patient, getting into the teeth of the defense, getting into the lane, waiting for the defense to converge, and then you hit it to your big man, you ride your horse down the stretch. Thomas Gibson, great job going up strong.
Luke Adams actually was called for the foul there, so that's the first foul on Adams. And if Gibson gets a little bit stronger, a little more confident, he's going to be stuffing those balls.
I don't know if we want Gibson to get any stronger, Doug. He's among the strongest in the Big 12 already. I think we need to cap out his strength.
A lot of big guys in the team. DJ Johnson is a man with a stout body.
I think you said it correctly with me. You just said man, because he is a man among boys. See him warming up and playing during practice.
Robert Kravic. Again, Kansas State making it difficult to score, although Gray had an open look. But they lead the Big 12 in scoring defense. Allowing just under 58 points a game, and they're on target again to come in just under that.
That was a play right there that Coach Weber wants Angel Rodriguez to pull it out. As a guy getting more mature, learning basketball, you got to know, you know, down the stretch, pull it out, wait, get a good shot. You don't need to go up in the lane and throw up a shot like he did.
And Gibson again goes to the left.
And that's what Texas Tech has to do. Right now they're in a position they have to make stops every time down. They can't continue to exchange baskets.
And the stuff. Very well done by Jordan Tolbert.
Jordan Tolbert.
And the foul.
Foul number 13, Angel Rodriguez.
Angel Rodriguez called for the foul inside.
Well, nice high-low pass. Kravic from way out in the perimeter. And Tolbert did the job early on with the nice seal on Shane Southwell. Went up strong, and you could hear that slap on his wrist all the way out here. And that strength and poise going up with that shot and creating the and-one opportunity.
Tolbert now with a season best 16 points, or at least Big 12 best, now with 17.
You see Texas Tech putting in that full court pressure. Kansas State didn't seem like they were ready for it.
Coming up this Saturday in the Big 12 Network, it's Studio 66 tipping things off at 12:30 Central Time. These are the East Coast times for our friends at West Virginia. because they play in one of the second games, West Virginia TCU or Texas Tech against Baylor. That first game should be interesting, Oklahoma State, Texas.
Actually, I think that Baylor-Texas Tech game is going to be the most exciting game on the slate.
You going to be there?
Actually, I think I might be there, Doug, now that you mention it.
I had a feeling that you're going to be down in Waco. Bruce Weber has really done an outstanding job inheriting a team that Frank Martin recruited, and he's put his own stamp on it. They defensively a little more help defense, a little more team defense, but they still like that man-to-man. And upcoming for Kansas State, gets awfully interesting. Iowa State, Kansas, Baylor, three in a row are all important games.
Yeah, and really, enough can't be said about what Bruce Weber's done. One of the more difficult things to do as a coach is to go into and establish a good team and sustain that. And you have a coach in Frank Martin that was beloved by his players. And they've embraced Bruce Weber, his style of play. Took him a while to get acclimated to it. But you see what makes him one of the better offensive coaches in the country.
Angel Rodriguez. Concentration at the line.
And for the Wildcats, number 42, Thomas Gibson. And for the Red Raiders, number 11, Dejan Kravic, number 4.
Thomas Gibson now back in for Kansas State. And Chris Walker continues to send players in and out. Dejan Kravic back in. For a second three-pointer of the season.
He's 50%, though. I mean, still like the numbers. Right now, you see the Wildcats. They're just going to milk the clock each time down the court.
1 minute.
Texas Tech might need to start fouling.
Rodriguez looks up. There's now 9 seconds on the shot clock. Southwell breaks the double team and just threw it too hard to Thomas Gibson, who wasn't quite ready for that fastball.
Even though Kansas State didn't come up with the basket, they did eat a lot of clock, about 28 seconds. So if they continue to do that, really won't have enough time for the Red Raiders.
Deep.
What a rebound.
And the rebound by Tolbert. Boy, Tolbert has been huge. Quick timeout from Texas Tech with 26.6 on the clock. And Tolbert now with 19 points to lead the Red Raiders.
I mean, Jordan Tolbert goes up with one hand and grabs it in the apex, and then goes up with that same hand and dunks it. If you want to know what athleticism means, look up in the dictionary right now, and you'll see Jordan Tolbert in his picture. That, along with that first play of the game, the tip dunk, have to be two of the most athletic plays I've seen all year long.
Well, Kansas State in the double bonus. And the referees are looking at the time just to make sure.
I disagree, Doug. The refs are looking at that offensive rebound and that dunk. They're thinking, wow, I want to see that again. We think they're looking at the clock, but really they're over there talking about Jordan Tolbert.
You saw the clock stop on the timeout at 26.6, and we'll see if they perhaps put a half a second back up on the clock. Season high for Jordan Tolbert. It's been a big night for the young man. Second-year player from Fort Worth, Texas. And they did change the clock now. They put it about a second and a half up there, so it's 28 seconds. Spradling can run the baseline. All handlers and all good free throw shooters in the game now for Kansas State. Magruder to Rodriguez. Time ticks away, and that'll do it. Red Raiders will back off, and that's a final from Lubbock, Texas. Bruce Weber and the Wildcats ranked number 13 in the land, a 68-59 winner, and they remain just a game or at least a half a game now behind Kansas, who plays against TCU tomorrow.
For me, their ability to win on the road, 7-8 on the road, has been the staple of Kansas State this year. You want to be good, you got to win on the road.
That's it from the United Spirit Arena, where the final score is Kansas State 68-59. The next Big 12 Network telecast is Saturday, where Oklahoma State takes on Texas, followed by a Big 12 doubleheader. We'll say so long from Lubbock, Texas.